My name is Nanko Dolman. I'm working at a consultancy firm called Royal Koning in Thailand, also known as Future Wolf Koning. I'm working there as a consultant in water and space planning. And outside Hans Koning, also a lecturer at the Hogeschool Rotterdam. Summer I was in Thailand, working at our office in the city. And actually they had this wonderful marketplace across the street where you can have lunch. And it's called Khao Su Mu, I think it was called. And it was really tasteful, and it's really different than from in the Netherlands. We have also this more like plain food with less spiced food. So, and I think it's more adventurous and more colorful to experience the Thai food. Looking at a water adaptive city, I prefer it calling more like water sensitive city, because it's also to do with awareness, and not only within innovation within techniques or in design. It is also to involve people, to make them aware about surroundings, living environment, so to include also the social and politic drivers. It's really important to have the transitioning to a water adaptive city. I think the people are working on the adaptive water adaptive city. It could be on different levels, thinking about more like planning process. And framework level is really important, because there has to be a strategy or a vision for us to be in the future, and not only to realize to fix problems on local plots or sites, but also to have it integrated in the whole context. And I think in when we have a tactical level and design level, we have to also to search for collaboration and alliance with different kinds of expertise. So I also think about putting designers with technical people like hydrology or hydraulics, but also ecology. Public and institutional organizations will be involved. It could be also in different directions. Institutional organizations have to think about maybe changing policies. But also, I think for community involvement, it's very important to have these people living in the city to have the opportunity or the challenge to be their own developer or their own entrepreneur in this kind of things. And I'm also thinking about the local scale solutions, and we call this ecosystem services, for example. You can actually have benefits in business for maybe to be a local water supplier, to have harvesting rainwater in the city, in the neighborhood, and then supplying it in the neighborhood for a small fee, and have also jobs in that, or a business. Actually, tomorrow I have a busy day at our university in Rotterdam. I'm working with students on transitioning of Delta cities. But we are discussing this with students, and think we have to invest in human capital to have the younger people to make them aware, and also to become their thinking that way. So, hey, I can be an entrepreneur, or I can to do something about this, reaching our water adaptive city. So that is to invest in the younger generation by investing in human capital is very I think that will be my task for tomorrow. The water adaptive city of the future is actually not that far away, I think. But it also has to, and you can see that it's in social media. Social media is evolving very fast and rapid. In India, for example, everyone has a cellular phone, but not everyone has drinking water. So we have to think about different ways in transitioning. So and we can also frog leaping in these phases to realize this water adaptive city.